In this video, I'm going to go over briefly some of the concepts of Office 2013 and how it differs from Office 365. Microsoft Office 2013 is a group of programs. They are designed to work together for creating documents, creating spreadsheets, creating presentations, and other even databases that are designed for productivity and also collaboration. These applications include Microsoft Word, Microsoft Excel, PowerPoint, and Outlook. Then it also depends on what version of Office 2013 you're getting. So if you're getting the professional version of it, then you'll probably have, besides the mentioned applications that I mentioned earlier, you also can get Microsoft Access or Publisher on the ultimate version, and also there is OneNote as well. Then there is also Office 365 that you might have heard. Office 365, it's basically the same set of applications that I mentioned earlier, but it's designed for it to be more a different licensing model. Instead of you buying a set of CDs and being allowed to install it only in one computer, or in some cases two computers, in this case, Office 365 is a subscription model that you basically pay every year, and then you're allowed to install, depending on what you purchased, you can install it on up to five computers. Now, there are two versions of Office 365. You have the for home edition of it, which is basically $9.99 a month. And this is designed for you to install it on up to five computers. This can be five PCs or Macs. You can install it on up to five tablets, even access it on a smartphone and offline storage, and also 1 terabyte of storage for up to five users online. Then you have also the Office 365 Personal, which is basically for the individual, for one user, and this is somewhat a little bit less expensive. So $6.99 a month, and you can see the different options here. And as of the time of this recording, they also have Office 365 online only, and the personal edition of it, it's free as of this time. Then there are also options of 365 here for business, and Office 365 for business, it basically has, again, it's a licensed model of it, which you can have $5 per month per user, and this is pretty much just online here. The first option here is just online. Then you have Office 365 Business, which is $8.25 a month. Again, this depends on the time when you go to subscribe for it, and you get also the desktop version of it, but you have to pay for it annually. You basically get this installed or available online for up to five PCs. And again, on tablets, smartphones, and so on. Then you also have the Home Premium, which basically between the business and the Home Premium, you basically get the business class email, unlimited online meetings, and social networking integration as well. So the idea here is that you have the traditional Office application 2013, that you can get the CDs installed in your computer, and you usually get, based on the version that you purchased, you get Microsoft Word, Excel, and PowerPoint on a basic version. Then if you go to the professional version, you usually get Microsoft Access added onto the basic version. Then if you get the Premier version, you can get also OneNote and also Publisher and Access. Of course, Microsoft Outlook is included in there as well, Outlook for email. So I know it's a little bit kind of confusing at this point with the different types of licensing, but the model basically is moving at this point more and more to Google Apps for education or Google Apps for work, where you pay subscription monthly or annually, and then you get access to your application or set of applications. And here is a brief video on how they intend to market Office 365.
365 is the office you know and love, on the devices you use most, whenever you need it, and virtually wherever you are. Beginning with Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and Outlook, Office 365 provides all the familiar apps you've come to depend on, along with a dynamic set of cloud-connected tools that help you communicate, collaborate, and get more done. With the flexibility of the cloud, your files are never stuck on your computer at work or your laptop at home. Office 365 lets you share and sync documents virtually anywhere and anytime you're working. Stay nimble and stay in touch. See your team's calendars, know when they're online, send them an instant message, or even communicate face-to-face. Better than that, work on the same document together in real time. You've got Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Outlook, and the rest of the Office family, all connected by cloud-driven features like co-authoring and video conferencing. Now combine that with automatic updates, a global network of expert support, and a 99.9% uptime guarantee. And what you get is 365 24/7 possibilities. Get it done at office365.com.
So there you have it. That's a marketing for Office 365. It's a continuous payment. You stop paying on year 2 and year 3 and so on. Then you lose access to the software. So each one of them has advantages. The 365 Online has the benefits of you having access anywhere on any type of device, and also multiple devices, up to 5 of them depending on what you purchase. But the traditional licensing way is that you purchase it once and you can use it for 10 years, you can use it 5 years, you can use it 4 years, and so on. So that's how it is. One important thing to keep in mind here as we are discussing the Office suites is that it's referred to as a suite because it is tightly integrated applications that are designed to work together, and you can transfer data from one to the other, or they can be integrated closely together. And also as a suite, it's designed to give you the full capability of you doing your job. So let's say one day you have to do a presentation, therefore you have PowerPoint. Another day you have to do calculations and budgets and so on. Then you can use Excel. And another day you're going to write a document or a proposal and so on. And in that case, you'll be using Microsoft Word. And then from day to day, you're going to use a messaging application. In this case, you'll be using Microsoft Outlook and so on. So all of these are designed to be a one solution from one company for you to meet your business needs, but yet also the data that you create in Excel or in Microsoft Access that we'll be using in this course, you can utilize it in Microsoft Word and in Outlook, and you can kind of reuse that content for different other purposes. So that's the concept of a suite. Hopefully it makes sense here, that it's a bunch of applications that are tightly integrated to provide you a complete solution and also to reuse the data that you create from one into the other. So for the rest of the semester, we are going to utilize Microsoft Office here, the traditional Office 2013, and understand some of the concepts and then see how those concepts relate. I'm going to teach the course from a concepts-based, what I mean is from a concepts-based approach, is that once you understand the concept in Microsoft Word or in Office 365 or in Excel or whatever we are using, you'd be able to apply that same concept in some other Office suite. For example, if you use Google Apps for work, or if you use OpenOffice and so on. An alternative to Office 365 is also Google Apps for work. Until recently, it was referred to as Google Apps, just simply Google Apps. The way it works is basically you get your email, you get your Google Sheets, like similar to spreadsheet software. You get Google Presenter, which is similar to the presentation software PowerPoint in Office, And you get all of those for a business environment, highly collaborative, meaning other co-workers, you can change the document at the same time with other co-workers and so on. And you can get that for $5 a month per user per month. And this is the typical one here on the left-hand side. And of course, you'd get also the email as well. And then $10 a month, this is with unlimited storage, plus the vault, which is basically the backup of the all the content on Google systems. So that's an alternative for you to consider. Now, for Google Apps for Education, you have access to this by simply going to your Cairn Gmail and Cairn Calendar and Cairn Sheets and so on, and you have access to that. And recently, actually, Google announced the unlimited storage for education on Google Drive as well. So that's something else to consider too. If any of those solutions do not work, then there is also open source solutions for productivity applications such as OpenOffice from openoffice.org. And OpenOffice, it gives you pretty much similar like it gives you the Office Writer, Calc, Impress, Draw, and Base, which is very similar, like counterparts to Microsoft Office. So you can download that from openoffice.org. The other choice is Libre Office. And again, LibreOffice, it's very similar to OpenOffice. I personally like LibreOffice a little bit more. It's a little bit more refined, it seems like. But it's free, and it's a good alternative to using it. So, as you start your business, as you start work in a business environment of your own, where you are cautious of expenses and annual subscription costs and so on, these are some of the options to consider.